director of clinical affairs at a medical device company in Sunnyvale, California.
And I'm Asha. I'm vice president of program management at an oncology company. It's a small biotech in the Bay Area as well.
So I do agree that the gender biases are pretty strong in the corporate world in terms of males and females. Men do tend to get ahead quickly, they get promoted more, and what's really disheartening is that the salaries are disproportionate. Mm-hmm. A woman gets paid 81% of a man's salary for the same exact job. And this balloons over time, obviously. So data has shown that between the ages of 16 and 24, so for the younger generation, the difference in salaries is not that much. It's only about 95%. Mm. So girls get paid 95% of the guy's salary. But as time goes on, and with raises being less for women as compared to men, this balloons. And a higher level, a director or greater level, the same job gets paid 81% of the man's salary. So that's a problem. And it's not that men and women are less ambitious. Women are, if not more, they're equally ambitious than men. Mm-hmm. They are also more educated.
I think the things that will work for a woman are pretty much the same things that work for a man, but perhaps you need to make a greater effort, right? So the things that have worked for me, you have to be good at what you do. You have to be confident about yourself. You have to have good communication skills. You have to be able to express your thoughts really well. There's no getting around this. You have to be good at what you do to start with, right? So the question is, do your job well, be well prepared, do all that, and then make sure that you fight for what you deserve. You know, it took me a while to get to that place because we are brought up to not really like talking about money. We don't like to go and ask for a raise. But those are things that fortunately age has sort of
that you learn over time. Yeah. You learn it the hard way, but she's absolutely right. If you have direct reports, a good manager, try to mentor people. Try to make sure that if you have people reporting to you, they are quickly rising in the corporate ladder.
This issue about mentoring, what really helps everyone, male, female, is if you're fortunate enough to have a mentor early on in life, right? Mm-hmm. So male or female, there's nothing better in order to succeed than having a mentor. Mm-hmm. And as women, what we need to do more, and I think we are, as you succeed and do more, you're trying to be a mentor to others. I have to say that I don't specifically go out and say I'm going to mentor only women, but I try to mentor whether it's women, men,
right,
anybody who's interested in, and is looking for a mentor. I try to do that.
And a mentor is not just, that person will not be your mentor for just that period when you're working with him or her. It will be a lifetime relationship. Remember, you'll need this person going forward for your other jobs as well as a reference or for advice. The first thing to remember for the younger kids is that from day one, you have to maintain a poise and a certain behavior at work. Very important, dress appropriately, dress for work. If you see anything directed to you, do not be afraid of pointing it out to whoever's directed. Or if there's an HR department at work, go talk to them. Do not be afraid of being called a loser or not participating in jokes or not being able to take a joke, because you have to for yourself draw that line as to what's a joke and what's not. Don't be afraid to point that out.
I have really not had any overt, actually not even covert, sense of sexism, or especially sexual harassment. Mm-hmm. I've just not experienced it. And it's not because I don't know it or cannot recognize it. I have walked on many a street in India and recognized it exceedingly
right.
Well.
Right.
Right? So we know what it's like. I don't mean to make the woman the cause of the behavior. The behavior is bad no matter what, but it just makes sense when you're at work dress professionally because you don't want to be objectified, and the best way not to be objectified is to dress in a manner that it's not the outfit that's the most visible thing. Mm-hmm. It's your confidence, it's your personality, it's your ability. Exactly. That's front and center.
You know, somebody asked me, I was not promoted, but my male counterpart was promoted. How should I deal with this? Should I go and complain to my boss? And my advice was, complaining is not the right attitude. You go to your boss, talk to him and say, what do I need to get to this position? Get all the metrics. Okay, so I need to complete this project by so and so. And get all of that documented and then say, okay, if I finish all of this, as we discussed, would I be promoted to this level? I do want to meet those expectations. Tell me what I need to do. You are seen as a positive person. You're seen as somebody who is ambitious. Mm-hmm. And
I took about 3 years where I was still consulting. I was just working on my terms. I wasn't doing the 60-hour week. I was just burnt out at the time, and I just decided I would take a couple of years off and work at interesting projects. Fortunately, I had the opportunity mm-hmm. to do that. So what I made sure I did was, of course, spend as much time with my family, you know, exercise, do all the things that are, you know, that I cherish. Do a little bit of writing, do a lot of reading, visit family and friends as much as I could. But I stayed relevant and current. You know, I kept in touch with my colleagues. I kept in touch with my co-workers, my mentors, my friends. And I was, you know, what I did, interestingly enough, is I actually expanded my net even more than when I was just at one job. So what was interesting is before that I had been, you know, in a particular drug delivery side, technology side that's very technology based. And what I did as I was doing this, my consulting, was I started going into, you know, other therapeutic areas where I was very interested. So sort of vaccines, then I got interested into in oncology. I was really, really interested in cancer drug development, which I had not done before, and which is sort of a specialized area. And what that allowed me to do was very nicely step into a pretty senior role. I mean, I came back at an absolutely comparable level. I mean, I didn't have to take any cut in salary, in anything. The important thing was that they felt I was still valuable. I was able to, you know, because I had been dealing with these issues even during my time off. My advice to people is if you are taking the time off, make sure that you stay relevant. I mean, I don't like keeping in touch with sort of the network, especially, you know, in terms of networking. It's not something that I seek to do, or I'm very good at doing, but that's something that, you know, you really have to do, and make sure that you are disciplined about that.
I personally don't think that the work-family balance should be gender specific. I think it's equally important for men to have that work-family balance as it is for women. I personally work because that's my identity. I want to work, I like to work, and I think I'm a happier person.
One of the mistakes I made early on was trying to do everything and do everything really well. And in the process, you know, I was really exhausted a lot of the time.
So you've got to find ways to be able to prevent that from happening. Do things for yourself. What I like to do for myself is exercise. I mean, that does wonders to me, and I need my time with my workouts and or read or write. I mean, if I'm traveling, I have to make sure my husband's in town and vice versa. If I have an important meeting that's going to last till 9 p.m., I need to make sure he's going to come home to be able to get dinner to the kids. Oh yes, it's got to be, you know, you have to have your spouse participate in this 100%.
But don't try to do it all yourself. So if I had to, again, distill all that into two words, I would say get help.
Those are the secrets to success.